fucking like playing Los Angeles, how much fucking pressure there is. I mean, you got all these goddamn fucking musicians in there, you got all these fucking stars, you got all these people that fucking, everybody knows their name, you know what I mean? We're just a crew, we're just trying to do our job, we're trying to make sound, we're trying to do laser, we're trying to get back in there and make like a, you know, a documentary, this thing, and I've got the sprinklers on. Well, that's just fucking great, man, that's just great, they got fucking sprinklers on. And here's like some, just some regular people here, and they're just like, trying to get
this
on this
is what
thing.
Los Angeles does to you.
Wait, wait. What'd you do with it?
Where is it? God damn it! Fucking camera's rolling. Who's that? It's the big guy.
That's the banner.
Come on. All these guys work on your life.
Look.
I'm getting sick and tired of your shit. You're on a thin
Everything
streak.
Everything I do twice because of you.
You're doing it twice. You got your fucking balls.
Emotions run high on the last show of this tour.
But come on, we'll show you.
Why the fuck do I have to do everything twice,
motherfucker? Is hang these fucking pieces of foam under here. Everybody fucking hates it. I fucking hate it. But if it's 10 till 5 and you need some foam,
look,
honey, come to me,
too.
Bob Hickey, Foam King. This is where I live and work for the last 5 months. This is called front of house. You can see our nicely carpeted little living area here.
This is beautiful. It's like home.
We'll start with this rack here. Here I have my 3 Wendell drums, a set of microverbs, serial numbers 0 through 4 BSS noise gates, some fucked up Aphex gates, my power supplies. Here are all my effects returns and another little effects rack under here. I've got Buford's great AMS, SPX90, a Quantech, a couple of tube techs and some cool shit. They're made in Denmark. Little RTA. That's some garbage here. Those are my effects returns on this board. Here's my main fucking board. I'll turn on the lights for you. This is where I spend most of my time worrying, fretting, and doing my art, as they say. This is Buford's board right here. It's one of these new Yamaha boards. He sits here and does his art, you know what I mean? Here's the new DBX RTA. This is the only thing we have to look out here besides women.
And Buford's chair. Here.
And this is Buford's chair. We've had a lot of trouble with these fucking
new
wheels.
New customized wheels.
Customized. Got new customized wheels. Buford put it up. Oh. I'm not supposed to see that. But we take them off every night, see, so that they don't fall off in transit. We lose them. And then Buford's little rack full of limiters and stuff.
But he doesn't do anything with them.
A drawer. We keep a lot of magazines and stuff in here because sometimes we do get bored. This is our quad board here. You pan these little things around, it makes sound go around the room. That's one of our quad speakers. That's another one of the quad stacks. These kind of give the feeling of being back in your living room in the quadraphonic days, you know? There's Mr. Mark Brickman with a cigar back there. He's in charge of the whole fucking set of lights up there. He's the guy with this crazy motherfucker.
Sitting fat tonight.
He's sitting back fat tonight. Salmonella, he's over.
And they're not even here?
Looks great.
Smoke is my game.
Here we are. We're fixing to leave this country. Go to some other country. There's Scott the guitar player. There's Eddie. There's Deborah. She's got a tan. She's waving her hand. There's John White waving his hand.
And yeah. This is going to be the video tour of the Eddie. Man, look, take this little Camroid.
Here's Ziggy Joe Bob.
Hey, bro.
How are you?
All right, how about yourself? Pete! He's alive!
Barely.
And there's Dirty. She's here. The new singer.
Ziggy Joe Bob.
Dueling camcorders. As you were saying.
Welcome to the longest flight in the world. You can't possibly go anywhere further in the United States without leaving the world, without leaving the atmosphere. This plane flight is 11 hours to Tokyo and then another 11 hours to Australia. You are going to die.
I mean, whenever I'm in Tokyo in Narita Airport, I always get a sandwich and a Diet Coke for $5.65.
That's a box lunch.
You notice that the crust is not included.
That's another $5.
That is an extra.
They don't have Dodger dogs. No Dodger dogs here.
No Sky Dogs?
No Sky Dogs.
What do you think about this, eh?
Banana juice.
Hey, $3 a pop. It's good, man. I just had $7 worth.
Banana juice. What's in that, though?
It's like a smoothie.
Banana juice. That's it.
Banana. Smoothie.
Some banana malt.
Yeah. I was cooking stuff up.
That shit's sweet. You dig?
Way down there, you go to the left. Yeah. Yes. Remember, you better be able to tell this to them later on. Go up 3 flights of stairs, and you'll see the New York people waiting in the waiting lounge above gate 20. There.
How do we know where they're New York people?
Well, you see, it was horrible. I ate the Japanese noodles.
He's Seth Goldman.
wonderful man about town, a lovely, lovely frown.
The new Paul Jones sound, okay? The haircut, the very clear eyeballs, you'll notice they're not red at all. And I'm going to tell you that I have a new future in town. Future on tap. I'm going to be a real-life video commentator, just like my idol, Bob Hickey. Okay? And I want you to know that Scott Ritt, right here, Scott Ritt, Mr. Scott Ritt, is one of my most vocal supporters. Let me hold this, Scott. Thanks very much. Let me hold this for me. Okay, this guy here, he's going to be my first subject. Look at that, Bob Hickey with his hand in his hands, as usual. You got it, man. The guy is a natural. Okay, no. I'm going to eat that. I'm going to eat that, and I do not want any of his fresh bodily fluid in mine, okay? Right,
what exactly is this?
It's Japanese spaghetti. Except as it is, it's called fried noodles, okay? Yeah. Basically, it's like...
But it doesn't have any meat, does it?
Doesn't have any meat in it, no. But see, what this is, it's like cat entrails performed on a plate, all right? You can see the red portions here.
Can I see you put that in your mouth?
Now, listen, don't get fresh with me, young man, but let me just show you how it works.
Mmm.
Oh, I'm telling you.
Mmm.
I'm telling you. This.
Steve, yes. Let's hear that one more time, Jeff, huh?
Caught in the swirling cesspool of their own steaming desires.
Yeah.
Stevie the Greek.
I'll stick.
Oh, I'll stick too. I am. Oh, that's what I got.
As Seth Goldman tries to get out of where he was stationed.
He's got that gun winner that you can't believe.
This is something that has to be dealt with. I mean, did that man in the red maroon turban back there, get a picture of him, the guy in the maroon turban, see him way back there? They didn't search him, but me they searched because I had change in my pocket. And I really feel this is a statement of the times and the anti-American feeling that is growing around the world as part of Reagan's economic policies. I think it's got to change. That's just the way I feel.
Scott, how long you been on an airplane?
Let's see, we've been 45 hours total now. You know, I'm really getting tired of being on this plane, too. In fact, I can't see sit here much longer. I don't know about everybody else.
Well, I mean,
it's been a good flight, you know? I mean, I've had some fun. I got drunk 4 times. You know? It's over and drunk. That's been interesting. I never did that before.
Well, here we are in New Zealand now.
Yeah, we finally made it off the plane.
Eastern, don't check your bags enough. They lose them.
What, Mark?
They suck. Eastern, they suck.
Well, what'd you lose?
He lost all my scuba gear.
Oh, no. First they lost your clothes, now they lost your shoes.
I can't even go to the swimming pool without my scuba gear.
Here we are, it's about like 80 degrees. Look at all these fuckers
nice.
Smiling, huh?
We are smiling. We're happy to be here.
I tell you. Yeah. New Zealand. Everybody's got camcorders, too.
Mere words cannot express my
feelings. We are here.
Rolling again.
Come on back.
You want to see more of?
Boy, live in the Springs, January 22. Tickets will be limited, so get them now.
Sydney, a man known on racetracks all over the world. Here we are, they're just kind of putting the stuff up. Herr Wiesman in charge once again. Herr Wiesman. How's it going?
Smear grease on your lens.
Yeah, there's a lot of me laughing on this. I just kind of have to appease the folks. Hey, a mountain bike. Dig it. This is a different roof than we use in the States. kind of a big little thing, isn't it? Brian Lucas, electrician. AC. What a thing. I guess that's my home out there. Man. Dinner time, just give him a little ticket here. Cafeteria. Mark Brickman, Lying Desire.
This is the schedule for tomorrow. It's not engraved in stone any more than today's was. The movement of these containers is rather slow because of the backlog of trucks that are waiting down at the harbor there's trucks waiting down there to pick up containers. They're lined up for about 15 trucks strong, so it's a little slow getting them out. But assuming we're going to hold on some hands tonight, they'll get these two containers out to bring two more containers in.
I have 20 hands coming. I have 26 hands calling. Six tomorrow morning. We'll go to the one place.
Have you lost your track too? You know, I have one.
That's okay. And I'll have 20 hands at 8 o'clock, dividing up, you know, for trusting and whatever else I got.
And I think this is a total disregard of respect if you're going to pull this crap again.
Listen, you guys are probably all drunk.
Instead of that drinking crap that Ross is talking about, instead of that drinking stuff, why don't we talk about these fucking projectors? I've seen 20 of them, and I don't like it. You don't have no written guarantee from Pink Floyd to do this, and I'm sick and tired of it.
What are you trying to say?
How can you have any respect for a guy?
John Belushi goes, no.
Jack Blackjack splits face cards.
No.
How can he do that? How does that work?
What is this cycle bell? Bullshit.
Personally, I cannot understand what the man's trying to say. I wish he'd stop beating around the bush and come right out and speak his mind. I hate people that are fucking wishy-washy.
What are you thinking?
That's assuming that there's a month present. So what do you want to do? You want to unload PA truck at 8:30?
If they want to unload it early.
That's a fucking piece of power cable right there. Here's a C container. That's what all our stuff's in, about 20 of those.
Says it's recording up
there. Hi, how are you?
And it'll tell
you. Hey, I'm okay. It's our first day down here in New Zealand. I've been up for about three now. I didn't sleep a little bit on the last plane ride. We're thrilled to be here, though.
Well,
did I wake up in Austin or Oakland?
What am I doing?
45 hours of sheer excitement so far.
Important cities. I can't tell the difference.
We have a fire here, folks. And here, this is K-Dog reporting from the Hyatt Hotel in Auckland. And we have a major incident here. The fire engines are here.
Well, it's day two down here. I've been here since, I don't know, a couple hours or something. It's the 20th, and it's, you see what time it is on the screen now. And they got up PA. It certainly doesn't look like enough PA to me, but we'll find out here in a little while. Screen's up. Wind's going to be a factor with that. It's a new roof we've got here. It's a European roof. We got most of our boards up. I haven't wired anything yet, but hell, I just had lunch, you know. Well, let's see, it's the middle of the afternoon. It's got the new scrim, but they already put black up so we can't see it yet. Looks like the stage is rolled in. There's the lighting truss. They're taking the thing off the screen. There's a laser platform. It's a pod.
Yeah, 13 and 4 stage left, 16 in the Duque stage, right?
Hey, Pete.
Bobby Hickey, king of the wild frontier.
Upstage right with the hot.
Yes, Jeff?
Did you see if you got anything out of the patch?
C'est une chose merveilleuse, le soleil brille, il fait très beau. It is a beautiful thing.
Two. As you can see, the boys are working hard by 12 the next day.
Two. One, two.
Well, here we are working on Buford's goddamn fucking chair. It's been a pain in the ass for fucking 60 shows. Looks like it's gonna be another pain in the ass for another fucking 60 shows.
Case in point, a young man, fairly healthy, fairly slim. He went on the road. He's a broken man, a mere shell of what he used to be. Soon he's gonna get a white cane and a dog.
Highs, minus 6 and 6K. High mids, 2.2K minus 8.
Check. 8, 2.
Always a new composition being composed here at PF Central.
One.
Working hard, Scott, or hardly working?
Just doing droid maintenance.
Hey, Bob, how are you?
Okay, how about yourself?
Pretty good, thanks.
What's that mean in New Zealand? For us, it's this one. Just the middle one, yeah. And in Brazil, it's like this. Yeah. What do you guys do? Just hang?
Not much. Drink piss and
Wellington.
Wellington. Where's that? You here for the concert?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I work for him. Yeah.
Why? Is it right?
Do I sound like I'm fucking around from around here?
No.
I'm one of the sound men. We just had dinner. I just got for about 20 more minutes and we're going to rehearse.
Is it right? Is it rehearsing?
Yeah. You'll hear it.
Listen to it rehearsed, though?
Hey?
Would you listen to it rehearsed?
You can listen to it from right here. It'll be loud enough, I guarantee.
Hey, where's this video going? Where are you going to put this video? Man?
Fucking in my hotel room when I'm, you know, I don't know. I don't know, man, you know.
Where what do I know?
It's my new toy. Huh?
Whereabouts are you from?
Texas.
Texas,
yeah. United States.
Davidson, Korea.
I gotta go, though. What you reading, Paul? Everything's just a rumor on this tour, isn't it?
Hey, the movie's out now.
There's the inevitable bed. It's gonna go on this cable from some tree up there. It's like a football game.
Turbo subwoofers, those big 24-inch things.
Yeah, I've never seen
that. I've blown two of them.
Oh,
really? Yeah, I blew some of those.
Grand the conk in hand.
It was fun, but
Go for it.
Yesterday I was oh, that's a good reason. I was flying with huge pink jackets. Some people
said great
it
vibe.
Looked like a plus two. Who's that say these words to the people that were looking at it? They were mesmerized.
The bus is here, gentlemen.
Saying, it was saying,
far away the gig, yesterday in Australia, a UFO picked up an automobile.
No, it didn't.
It didn't?
No, it did not.
What happened, Pete?
Mass hysteria, group psychosis, mass hallucinations. Some people theorize LSD in a general water supply. Myself, I think a new strain of wild mushroom was ingested into the last batch of Campbell's soup that they shipped over there.
But, you know, there's a lot of theories. However, it's just... Others say it was something large and pink saying, one of these days.
I thought the last large pink one of these days died off some time ago, but one can never know.
Oh, she's coming right at us! Look at those! Look at those!
You know, Mark Griffin, do you have a comment about this?
Yes. I love them. I need them.
Look at
I
this.
Want one.
That's another one.
Look at those! Oh, bajungas!
Big gobs of
you can tell. You can tell it's show day, folks.
Yes.
That girl has got some shoes long on. Legs that go all the way up to her ass.
Well, you can tell complexion of the grounds have changed a little. Our little football game has gone off the squire because all these fucking people have come in here invading our game. What do you have to think about that, Steve? Pretty much a drag, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a real big drag. Every year this happens, and every year we're going to say we're going to do something different, but we keep dragging our feet, and it's just an abomination.
Been on any pony rides?
Pony ride? We're gonna go on a water slide the next break.
A water slide?
Uh-huh.
God, it seems like guys are always getting to go on water slides. I'm always having to work.
Hi, I'm from the crowd and I want to meet Dave Gilmore.
Well, I'm afraid that's not really possible.
If anybody out there in camera land knows Dave, I would really like to meet him and get his autograph.
Grab the camera and run. Grabbing the camera.
They're starting to chant already. But again, they're foiled by radio. It better not be because there's no crew.
Holy shit, they're starting early. The band's on stage. It's only 7:30. We're fucked.
What prompt is this?
Hey, zoom in on some really gorgeous Auckland women. They're out there.
There's another casualty.
Another casualty.
Cat just fell down. I don't think he's coming back up.
Philadelphia.
Exciting. Pete likes this blonde tramp in the leather. Is that the one of your choice, Pete?
Yeah. Leather just does something for me.
Okay, go hit on her, Pete. No, not her, the blonde chick. Go hit on the blonde chick.
I don't know if I can do this on camera.
Come on, man. How about these chicks? Do I hit on them?
No. Kind of nice and kind of ugly.
She'll go for it, man. She ain't got nothing better to do.
She ain't got no shoes on.
Oh, and hoes. Dear boy.
I missed my calling. I should have been a ballerina.
Guitar.
Look,
Bobby, it's a pig playing a guitar.
A pig playing a guitar? No, that's a girl.
That's a cow.
I think. Or is it a pig?
Oh, you're tell. Right.
I don't do it barnyards is. That well.
Oh, this is great.
Hey, Bob, they've still got hippies here.
Margaret says that it's a wonderful day to be alive, especially when you're making money.
It's a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. We'll be like real newsmen, okay? We're going to catch the feelings, the ambitions, the hopes and the fears of the people that come to a Pink Floyd concert in Auckland, New Zealand.
All right.
On this Friday, which is January the 20th. 1988.
It's the 22nd.
How you going, man?
What up, Glenn Wallace? No, I'm sorry, but you're facing the camera in the wrong direction.
Peter Gillihan.
This lovely blonde girl right here.
Put some fries on me.
What is your name? Mandy? Hi, Mandy. What brings you to the Pink Floyd concert in Auckland, New Zealand on this Friday, the 22nd of January in the year 1988?
I like
the music. Do you like their new album or the old stuff better? Well, you'll enjoy the show. Spectacular show. My man Bobby here makes it sound better than it's humanly possible. He also takes the documentary.
Why, Bobby?
I love anybody because this film will probably be seen by almost nobody.
What do y'all think about that, huh?
Well, you can say hi, Mom, or something.
Who are
like that.
Y'all?
Hi, Mom.
Make sure.
Well, I think we should move on to more interviews. We'll see you later.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoy the show.
Bye-bye.
Okay, Pete.
Okay, you're on a roll now. Let's go.
Hey, Robin.
Hey.
We'll be right along.
And this is an articulate individual we have in the blue tank top there, isn't it?
Yeah, she's cute. She
we like
be.
Her, yeah.
Yeah, we like
yeah,
her.
Yeah, we can interview her.
Hi, I was just wondering, what is a Big Ben tie?
Oh, yeah. You got my chest. You had a bit of what? Oh, yeah? That's a good thing. Floyd night.
All right.
I'm not a bee.
And how are the hot dogs here in New Zealand?
Oh, they're beautiful.
They are.
Absolutely beautiful. So I haven't had any tea, and I've had a bit of booze. Tequila?
Yeah?
Hippie Lopez tequila.
They have tequila here in New Zealand?
Yeah. Hippie Lopez. So, like, I needed some hot dogs to sort of bring it down so I'm not so pissed. That's cool now, eh?
Hey, yo.
Excuse us, dear. Bob, here we have two girls in matching t-shirts which have been drawn by the magic and the mystique of Pink Floyd. Some people say the mistake, but they're wrong. Good evening, ladies. What are your names?
Serena and Vanessa.
Serena and Vanessa? Hi, how are you? As you can see, we're busy right here making the official, unofficial documentary of Pink Floyd. We've been doing this for 5 years. What's wrong with you?
Music?
Have you been a fan of Pink Floyd for long? You don't really look old enough to have been a fan of them for too long, but...
How's this going?
Bob? Some shots of the banner. That's their banner.
Wait a minute. You made this?
You probably didn't think that...
Wow. That's pretty heavy. How long did it take you?
About 3 days.
3 days?
Oh, off and on.
Off and on. Funky but cute.
They're coming on like lemmings. It's amazing.
They're coming to the sea like lemmings.
One more time, come on. Man, the legend, there he is. Redesigning set cards as we speak with the help of our production manager, Mr. Morris Light, a legend, a horse breaker, a Texan.
Just for fun, you know? Just for us, so we can kind of like history, you know? What's your name?
Here.
Hi, I'm Bobby.
You need to watch the concert?
You bet.
Yeah, way to go.
And opens possibly to 89 FM, a crowd to present you with Pink Floyd, who will take center stage.
I would be honored to point this out to you now. If you'll take a look, this young girl, right over the 16 channel line is 440 extended. And the one right here, okay, this is suspended. Especially that, excuse me, miss. Miss, your friend. You might look like the camera for a minute. Yeah, that's it. Turn around, give us a full view. I think they're shot.
It's very possible.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Our first intercourse, so to speak, interaction with some New Zealanders. They're actually camera shy. Don't you worry. When she leans over later on, she will be absolutely amazed at the size of her fabulous mammalian protuberances.
Bravo!
big, beautiful boobs.
Didn't I tell
you? You're right. She does. She does. She does. And you are just as cute as you can be. How about a peek behind those glasses, huh?
She's beautiful. Come on, wave.
Which chick?
She's beautiful.
Which chick?
Of course.
This one I'm aiming at right here.
Of course, you understand the microphone is on. We do have some real life commentary.
This one's on.
What are they doing, Lauren asks? They're living, Lauren. They're living live at a rock show. Sorry you asked now, eh? Conference,
Mr. Jim Thompson.
Well, of course, it's only a hypothesis on my part, but based upon the step one of the scientific method, known as observation for purposes of gathering data, I would say that this young girl is suffering from an excess of alcoholic beverage within her system. It's just a guess on my part.